60 Minutes Plus is looking at the continuing fallout from a dark period in our history. For decades, it was legal to send someone to prison in the state of Louisiana, even if the jury was not unanimous. These so-called Jim Crow juries were created after the emancipation of slaves to make it easier to imprison people of color. Louisiana voters overturned the law 3 years ago, but many people incarcerated under those juries are still fighting for a retrial. 60 Minutes Plus correspondent Wesley Lowery spoke with 52-year-old Anthony Bolt, who's been in prison for decades.
There are 1,600 men and women still incarcerated, some of us serving life sentences without probation, parole, or suspension of sentence, predicated on a law that was devised to reinstitute slavery in the state of Louisiana.
In 1994, Bolt was charged with second-degree murder and second-degree attempted murder after a shooting at a house party left one man dead and both Bolt and another man wounded. He insists he was not the shooter, but acknowledges he had a physical altercation with the victim that night. The following year, Bolt was convicted.
Do you remember the day that the verdict came in?
Oh, yes, like yesterday.
What was that day like for you?
It wasn't shocking that I was convicted. It was kind of like a numbness. And when I discovered that I was convicted by a non-unanimous jury, it went from a numbness to a shock, really.
The jurors had been split, with 10 voting to convict and 2 voting to acquit. In nearly every other state in the country, that tally would have resulted in a hung jury and a mistrial. Instead, Bolt was sentenced to life in prison.
So 2 of the jurors voted to acquit?
Yes.
What did you make of that? The idea that 2 jurors said, this guy's not guilty?
Well, at the time, to be honest, I was under the impression that you had to be convicted by a unanimous jury.
So you didn't even realize this could happen?
No, not at the time. I was young, and I had never been to trial.
And how did you feel when you realized that?
I just couldn't believe that I was going to be sentenced to spend the rest of my life in prison where 2 jurors found me not guilty.
Do you consider that an injustice?
Of course it is. Of course it's an injustice.
And Wesley Lowery joins us now. Wesley, doesn't feel right, and voters in Louisiana actually decided it is not right. They overturned this law 3 years ago. What happened?
So it's a little bit complicated. As you guys noted, right, these laws were put in place following emancipation because Louisiana wanted to take steps. They said this explicitly in the state legislature to retain a system of white supremacy, keep it easier to keep locking up black men and black women. This law stayed in the books for a century, right? Up until just a few years ago, you could be convicted with just 9 or 10 votes for conviction. So you could have 2 or 3 jurors who said this person's not guilty. Voters in Louisiana overturned the law, but what that did was it meant that people couldn't be convicted on split juries moving forward. It didn't do very much for someone like Anthony Bolt, who had already been convicted by a split jury. The Supreme Court would later come in and kind of uphold what the Louisiana voters said. They said, look, it's clearly unconstitutional. This can't work this way. But even the Supreme Court did not apply that ruling retroactively. So again, meaning people who had already been convicted by a split jury remained in prison. What we're seeing now is a campaign led by formerly incarcerated people, local activists, public defenders, who are fighting to try to figure out some level of recourse for the 1,600 or so people who are currently in prison in Louisiana, having been convicted by a divided jury. And so in some cases, district attorneys are reviewing their own cases in their jurisdictions, as the case in New Orleans. There's discussion in the state legislature about passing a new law that maybe would grant automatic retrials to people or have the governor's office renew it. But again, in the meantime, we've got 1,600 people who were convicted in a way that the U.S. Supreme Court, in a pretty scathing opinion led by conservative justices like Neil Gorsuch, that have said, look, this is clearly racist, clearly unconstitutional. And yet today, as we're chatting, Anthony Bolt is still in Angola.
One person would be too many. 1,600 is truly a travesty. We hope there is some movement in their cases. Wesley Lowery, thank you very much.
Of course. Thanks for having me.
You can watch Wes's full report right now on 60 Minutes Plus. It's available on the Viacom CBS streaming app, Paramount Plus.